Hello, I am Vaishali. Today I am here with a new video on operation research. This is a very requested video, branch and bound method. So the one thing I want to explain you about what is branch and bound method. First thing is branching means you have seen a tree, they have branches. Okay, so branches means division. When you divide a big thing or a thick thing into small things, that is called as branching. Division, modularity, branching, all are the similar terms. Okay, similarly here what we divide, you can ask me, here we have the given LPP. In this LPP you have to divide this LPP as a further sub problems. So that sub problem 1 divided into 2 further sub problems, sub problem 1, sub problem 2, that is called as branching. Okay, now I just want to explain you branching by a small diagram. See, if we have a big problem, that I'll term as problem 1. If I have a big problem, okay. Problem means a question, anything which you want to solve, okay. Now, if I don't able to solve this problem full, I'm not able to get the answer. So, I divide that problem into small sections, or you can say the small sub problems, problem 2, problem 3, problem 4. Now individually I get the answer of problem 2, then I'll get the answer of problem 3, then I'll get the problem answer 4. So by summary of these 4, I can able to get the answer of problem 1. You understand the concept? If you are from a computer science, you can understand the term modularity. Modularity means dividing a problem, a big problem, into further sub problems. Then sub problems can be further divided into sub problems so that we can get and analyze the exact result and we can obtain the final answer, which is more appropriate. The same condition is given in the technique of branch. Okay, the branch term is clear to you. Now we move to the bound. What is bound? See, why, what we usually use the term bound. Bound means we are bounded to something, means we have the limits. Limits is bound. Okay, so bounding means limit. Something is limited, that is called as bound. Similarly, in this program, in this problem, we limit the variables. Variables means the variables on which the LPP is dependent, that means the decision variables. Okay, now each and every variable depending on the question will have their bounds, means will have their upper bound or the lower bound. Lower bound means the lower bound and the upper bound. The limits, lower bound and upper bound, will show the limits, the minimum limit and the maximum limit of the variable by which we can extend the values. Okay, combining these two terms together, branch and bound, these concepts we have to utilize to solve this LPP problem. I think this concept is clear to you. Now, this is only a general concept so that I can make the thing is more easier for you moving to the question. Use branch and bound technique to solve the following integer programming problem. This LPP is given to us and now we have to solve it. Now first thing is, I just term this is objective function. I just term this as 1. Okay. These are the two constraints. I termed this as 2. These are the limits which is already given to us. Means the variable of x decision variable is more than 0 and x2 variable is less than 7. Accordingly, we have to see this term as 3. Now, the restrictions x1 and x2 are integer type of variables. This I'll term as 4. I hope this thing is clear to you. Now, what I'll do, I'll not making a separate graphs and separate explanation. I'll just do the way you can do in your exam. At the first iteration, 1, 2, 3 will termed as subproblem 1. Now, we just make a subproblem 1 so we can analyze its result and we see if it is required, we do branching and with respect of bound, we obtain the result. Okay. Now, this is the first. So, I have to make a subproblem 1 including these things. Okay. Now, the subproblem 1 will contain the objective function. Objective function, I am writing it here. Max of z is equals to 7x1 plus 9x2. Okay. Then 2 are 2 constraint. Minus x1. I hope this is clear to you. Minus x1 plus 3x2 is less than 6. Third one. 7x1 plus x2 is less than 35. Okay, now the value of x1 and x2, that is 2. Okay, this is termed as your subproblem 1. Now, after writing the subproblem 1, the one step you have to understand, and the same steps will be followed till the end. First thing, this is not very difficult question, very easy question. What I suggest, whatever I am doing, you just copy it once. It will be very easy for you and you understand it. See, this is subproblem 1. After obtaining the problem 1, solve this problem and analyze the result. For solving this problem, in the branch and bound method, we use the graphical method. Okay, so every time you have to write the same step, use graphical method to find the optimum solution of the problem 1. This is problem 1, use the graphical method. For solving the graphical method, we have to find the values of x1 and x2, only then we can solve it. Now just writing it here, minus of x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. We have to write the constraint into form of the equation. Okay, now just get the value of x1 and x2 in this equation. X1, x2, putting x1 equal to 0, what we get? X1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. When we put x1 equals to 0, what we get? 3x2 is equals to 6. So x2 is equals to 6 by 3 is 2. So we'll put 2 here. Okay. Now next, put x1 equals to 3. Because we come to know now this is the multiple of 3. So we can take anything which is multiple of 3, putting x1 equal to 3. So minus 3 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. So 3x2 is equals to 6 plus 3. It will become 9 by 3x2. So you will get the answer 3. So when you put 3 of x1, you will get 3 of x2. It's your choice. I am putting the 3. I am obtaining the 3 values. You can do with 2 values as well. Okay. So x1 is equals to, I am taking 6 because I come to know this is multiple of 3. So I will just taking the values which is multiple of 3. So minus 6 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. Now 3x2 is equals to 6 plus 6. So this will become 12 by 3. So this will become 4. So this is x2. Okay. So these are the values for first equation. So x2 is 4 and x1 we put as 6. I hope this is clear to you. This is for first equation. That's in a form of equation. X1 plus x2 is equal to 35. X1 plus x2 is equals to 35. Now putting x2 equals to 0, because x2 is coefficient is 1, putting x2 equals to 0, 7x1 is equals to 35. So x1 is equals to 5. 0 and x1 is 5. Now next, putting x2 is equals to 0, putting x1 is equals to 0, x1 is equals to 0, we get 0 plus x2 is equals to 35. Okay, so we get x2 is equals to 35. X1 is equals to 0, x2 is 35. X2. See now, this is the multiple of 7. So I am putting the values in term of 7. Multiples of 7 only. So x2 I am putting as 21. So 7x1 plus 21 is equals to 35. So 35 minus 21 is equals to 7x1. X1 is equals to 14 by 7, 7 2s are 14, so x1 is equals to 2. This way also you can judge your equation, okay? So x1 is 2 and x2 is 21. So these are the three values. Now obtaining these three values, we have to make the line and solve this, okay? Of x1 is 0, 3, 6, 5, 2. So we can take a unit of 1 centimeter, that means 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have taken the same values for x1. Okay. In case of x2, the values are like 2, 3, 4. It is going 21, 35. So I have taken the scale of 5 centimeter. That means 5 units. Okay. So 5, 10, 15. Like this I have written. This is still x2. X1 is 0 and x2 is 2, so it will be here 0, 2. Now second one is 3 and 3. This is 3 and this will be bit here 3. Below 5, 3. Okay. Now for x1 it is 6 and x2 it is 4. So it will be below 5 and above to this I am marking it here. So this is equation number 1. So this is equation number 1. Okay. Values is 5, 0 and 0, 5. So 5 and 0. X1 is 5 and this is 5, 0. Next is 0, 35. That means X2 is, X1 is 0 here. 0, x1 is 0, so x1 is 0 on x2 line, okay, and the value is 35, so 0, 35 is this point, now 2, 21, 2 is x1 and 21 is x2, so it is below here, somewhat here, okay, now join this line, equation number 1, the line of the equation 1 and equation 2, now, the values is, this is less than this in first quadrant and this is less than this, okay, means it is this area. So what we can say, below this line, because sine is less than, both has less than sine. So you know, in the case of less than sine, we include the inner area, innermost area, so this will help us in finding the optimal solution. So before moving further, I want to explain you one thing more. In my question, it is given the value of x1 is greater than 0, so this will include for x1 above area, okay. Now for x2, less than 7, less than 7 means below this area, below 7, okay. So at anyhow, if I am not drawing the line, I can understand that this will be the most feasible region. Okay, this will be the most feasible region. So by this only we just get the points. So we have to find the values of these points to obtain the value of z. Like this is 0, 0, this is 0, 5 and this is 0, 2 and this is 5, 0. And this we have to obtain by solving these two equations. So I am solving the equation 1 and equation 2. This is the equation 1 and this is the equation. Minus of x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. 7x1 plus x2 is equals to 2. You will get minus 7x1 plus 21. X2 is equals to 42. Then 7x1 plus x2 is equals to 35. 22x2 is equals to 77. So x2 is equals to 7 by 2. Now putting the x2 values in any of the equation, I am putting in the first equation. So 7x1 plus x2 is equals to 35. 7x1 plus 7 by 2 is equals to 35. Now solving. So this is the value of x1 and this is the value of. Value of x1 and x2 we obtain at this point is 9 by 2 and 7 by. You have to calculate the value of z at all the points so that we can get the solution of the subproblem 1. Equals to 7x1. Z is equals to 7x1, 9x2, 7x1 plus 9x2. This is the value of z. You can say this is the equation of z. Now putting the values of x1 and x2. Value of x1 and x2 is 0, 0. Then next is 5, 0. Then next is 0, 2. Next is 9 by 2 and 7 by 2. Now putting the value of x1 and x2 in this equation, we can obtain the value of z. The max z will be the answer because the objective function is of maximization form. So you know this is 0, this is 7 into 5 is 35, this is 9 into 2 is 18, and this when you solve is 7 into 9 by 2 plus 9 into 7 by 2, so this will become 63. So the value of max of z will become 63. Okay, so this will be the maximum answer. So when z is equals to 63, x1 is equals to 9 by 2 and x2 is equals to 7 by 2. Okay, at the point, x1 is equals to 9 by 2 and x2 is equals to 7 by 2. Obtained solution is non-integer. So we have to solve it further. Okay, so this is the solution of subproblem 1. Now, before that, I want to explain you one thing, that when you do this type of a question, you have to make a tree diagram, T diagram of integer programming problem. That means here we have to write the solution of subproblem 1. This is solution of subproblem 1. Now, what is the solution of subproblem 1? The solution we'll be writing like this way. Max of z is equals to 63, x1 is equals to 9 by 2, x2 is equals to 7 by 2. So, I told you at the starting of the question that in this question, as the answer is not the integer form, so we have to divide the problem, subproblem, we have to divide the problem into two subproblem. This will become subproblem 2 and this will become subproblem 3. Okay, this will become subproblem 2 and subproblem 3. Now, I will tell you how to divide, how we can divide this problem. As the solution of subproblem 1 is non-integer, so we will see which integer we have to take. Now, this time we'll be taking the x1 integer because this is the first, so I'll be working for x1. So that means x1 is 9 by 2. We'll take the approximate value of it. 9 by 2 is we can take as an 4 and divide it into two subproblems. Getting x1 equal to 9 by 2 equal to 4 into 2 subproblems. So, you know 9 by 2 is equal to 4.5. So, approximate value we have taken as 4. Okay. Now, let think this is the value where we get the value of 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. So, these are the decimal values of 4. Now, we can think if here we can get the value of 4.5, around 4.5. So, its lower limit will become 4. Its upper limit will become 5. We can understand like this. So, this is the lower to upper limit of 5. Okay. Now, x1 is less than equal to 4. That means value before 4 and x1 is greater than equal to 5. So, these are the values which is become more than 5. Okay. So, x1 is greater than equal to 5 and x1 is less than equal to 4. So, here in left hand side, the 4 will become the upper bound, and in 5 and beyond that it will become the low. So 4 will become the upper bound and 5 will become the lower bound. Okay. Now including these two values will make the subproblem 1 into two different subproblems. Subproblem 2 and subproblem 3, we want a subproblem 1. Just copy it as such. This is the objective function. So, I am writing it here. Max of z is equals to 7x1 plus 9x2. Objective function 2 constraint minus x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 6. 7x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 35. So, this is clear to you. The same I'll going to write it here. Objective function. Now, after this term to subproblem 2. So, x1 is greater than equal to 5. And here x1 is less than equal to 4. So, we have removed that constraint. We have removed this from the subproblem 1, as this is already given in the question. This is already given in the question. We have removed that, and now we called as subproblem 2, and this full section is called as subproblem 3. Okay. Now, obtaining this subproblem 2 and subproblem 3, we have to apply the same technique. See, in books, they have given bit a different way. They are assuming the lower limits value of z and all the variables. Then they are making the master list of the variables, and then they are doing direct graphical method and writing the subproblems. While going in that way, it will become confused for the become a confusion for the students, because you are doing first time. So it better you just do once by the way which I am explaining you, and then you go through the problem of your book. It will be more easier for you to understand. Okay. Now, moving further, subproblem 1, same we have to do. We have to solve it by graphical method, and then we have to analyze the result. If we get the integer result, that means the values of the variables are integer, we have to stop at the same point. And if we get non-integer value, then again we have to divide, and then we have to put the bounds. Now, is this clear to you? Branching and bounding. Okay. Now, moving to solve problem 2. In problem 2, we have same equations like minus of x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6, which we have in the first one. The same it will be copied, two equations. 7x1 plus x2 is equals to 35. Now we have one thing more, that x equals to 5. This will work, but we have to see it will going x1 is greater than 5. Okay, that I will explain. Drawn, this is the graph which I have already drawn, and we have to copy the same values which we have done for sub problem 1. Only one constraint will increase, and this constraint is the limiting constraint. Okay, now see, for first equation we have values 0 and 2. So 0 and 2 means x1 is 0 and 2, so it will be somewhat here. Then 3, it will be somewhat here. Then 6 of x1 and 4 of this, it will be somewhat here, be 5. Joining this line, then again first one is done, second one, this is equation 1, then equation 2 is 5 0, this is 5 and 0, then this is 0 and 35 and 35. So joining these two points directly, I'm just taking first and second, go with third as well if you want. Now after these two lines, we have only one constraint, x is equals to 5. So line which is parallel to y-axis at 5, this way, but this will contain, now we have to see the region, this will containing the region below, means it is in the positive quadrant. Now this will also contain the region in the positive quadrant, this will contain the region, this will contain this full region, okay, this will containing this region, and this will contain the region like this, because this is greater than 5. I hope this is clear to you, this graph is clear to you. Now which is the common point, tell me. So this is the common point, this point is covering by each line, this line, this line, this line. How this line? Because this is containing the region below positive quadrant, so it will be till here. So first line will also covering this point, so only this point is the feasible point. Got it? So this is 5, x1 is 5 and x2 is 0. So this is only the feasible point for this sub problem 2. I hope this thing is clear to you. So now putting the value on z, max of z is equals to 7x1 plus 9x2. Okay, now putting the value, 7 into 5 will become 35. So we have only one value of z, z means z is equals to 35, for which x1 is equals to 5 and x2 is equals to 0. So this is the feasible solution for this optimal problem. Directly we can put the answer here. Now I'm just writing the answer here. Z is equals to 35. So max of z is equals to 35, x1 is equals to 5, and x2 is equals to 0. No branching and as well as no bounding of any variable, means there is no upper and lower bound of any variable value, because we have already in integer value. This thing is clear to you. Now moving for sub problem 3. In sub problem 3, this thing is clear to you. Step number 4, see, now same for step number 5. In step number 5, we are taking sub problem 3 by the graphical method and obtain the optimum solution. So we have to draw the graph, get the answer, and then analyze it. So what will be the sub problem 3? This is the sub problem 3. Okay, now sub problem 3, value of z, I am just writing it here, it is 7x1 plus 9x2 is the objective function. Constraint we have to write in the form of equation for solving it. x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. Now 7x1 plus x2 is equals to 35 and x is less than equal to 4. So this we have to solve and we have to plot a graph. So these are the values of x1 and x2, equation number 1 and equation number 2, plotting the same point, 0, 2, 0, 2 is this one, now 3, 3 is this one, and 6, 4 is this one, then 5, 0 and 0, 3, 5, this is 5, 0 and 0, 3, 5, this thing is clear to you. As we have to draw a line which is passing through 4 and parallel to x2, this, but less than 4, that means this is the region. For this line, this is the region. For this line, this is the region. So this is the most feasible region. Okay, so the points are 0, 0, 0, 5, and then this point. This point is 4, 0. So this point is the meeting point of 3 and 1. So taking 3, 3 is this one and 1 is minus x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. Now putting the value of x1 as 4 here, so minus of 4 plus 3x2 is equals to 6. So 3x2 is equals to 6. So 3x2 is equals to 6 plus 4. So 10, it will become 10 by 3. So value of x2 is 10 by 3. That means the solution which we obtain, this is 10 by 3 and the value of x1 is 4. So I am writing it here. This point will become 4 comma 10 by 3. Okay. Now after this, obtain the value of z. 7x1 plus 9x2. This is we have to see. Now x1 comma x2. Other is 0, 5. Okay. Other one is 4, 0. Other one is 4 comma 10 by of it. So this will become 0, this will become 45, this will become 28, this will become 7 into 4 plus 9 into 10 by 3, 3 threes are 7 fours are 28 plus 30, this will become 58. So this is the max of z. This is clear to you? So z has become 58. That means the solution which we obtain is max of z is equals to 58, for which x1 is equals to 4 and x2 is equals to 10 by 3. So this is the solution of problem 3. That means this is non-integer value and we have to further divide the value of x. Now obtained value of x2 is 10 by 3. That means it is 3.3 something. So that means if 3.3 comes in between, so its limits is 3 and 4. The limiting value will be 3 and 4. This is clear to you. So that means the value of x2 should be, s2 should be less than 3. That means it is going before values, values before 3. Okay, the values after 4 will be x2 will be greater than equal to 4. So that means this will become the lower bound 4. After 4, 4 till infinity you are going. Here 3 till 0 you will be going. So this will become the lower bound. And this will become the upper bound. So these constraints will be added with the new problem. These constraints will be added to the new problem. This thing is clear to you. Now we've got two constraints again. Now writing this sub problem 3 will be divided into two further sub problem. Sub problem 4, sub problem 5. This is clear to you. So we'll be using this as a base. So I'll be copying it. Z is equals to 7x1 plus 9x2 minus of x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 6. 7x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 35. X1 is less than equal to 4. Now this will become the sub problem 4. And this will become sub problem 5. So x2 is greater than equal to 4. X2 is greater than equal to 4. Now writing this same here. Max of z is equals to 7x1 plus 9x2 minus x1 plus 3x2 is less than equal to 6. 7x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 35. X1 is less than equal to 4. Same. These all will remain same. This all is sub problem 2 is copied. Okay, now this is new constraint will be added to sub problem 4. New constraint x1, x2 is less than equal to 3 is added to sub problem 5. Now this is clear to you. Now obtaining, after obtaining sub problem 4 and sub problem 5, we have to make a graph then analyze their result. Since the answer of sub problem 3, I want to write it here. Max of z is equals to 58, x1 is equals to 4 and x2 is equals to 10 by 3. So as this is non-integer value, so this will be divided into two sub-problems. Sub-problem 4, this will become sub-problem 5. So we will be going to write the result. Now see. This is subproblem 4 and this is subproblem 5. Now I'll be plotting the graph of subproblem 4 here. So I'll just explain you here so that you can compare them. Okay. And subproblem 5 here. Okay. Now for subproblem 4, you know that old points will be copied. draw the graph and then analyze the solution. The same 0, 2, then 3, 3, then 6, 4, then 5, 0, x1 is 5 and 0, then 35 and 0. And joining this, we will get for equation 1. This is for equation 1. So, the region will be in first quadrant, this one. And for this, it is this one. Okay. So, now, is less than 4, we have to plot these two as well. X1 is less than 4. So, that means x1, the line which is passing through 4, in parallel to x2. So, this side. This one will become line 4 and this one will become line 5. So, this is covering the region above it and this is covering the region below it. Graph, we does not get any feasible region. So, this graph will give you no feasible solution. And this problem will be dropped here. This does not have any solution. So, problem 4, we will be writing no feasible solution. Okay, now for sub problem 5. We will be using the same old points here for plotting the graph. And this one is 6, 4. This is equation 1. Then 5, 0 and 0, 35. Join these two lines. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. So, 1 and 2 is already plotted. Now, x1 is equals to 4 that we have to plot here. This is third line. Now, x2 is equals to 3. Sign less than. So, that means this will be the region for first line, second line, third line and fourth line. So, this is the feasible region. Okay, now just find the points x1 and x2. This is the feasible region. This is the line where x is equals to 4 and this is the line where x2 is equals to 3. So, this point will become 4, 3. This point will become 4, 0. This point will become 0, 0. This point will become 0, 2. Now, obtaining the value of all the points, we get the max of z value at x1 is equals to 4 and x2 is equals to 3. 55. So, this will be the feasible answer. Solution of problem sub problem 5, max of z is equals to 55, x1 is equals to 4, x2 is equals to 3. Okay, so as this is the integer answer, so this is the most appropriate answer for the question. Now, the final solution of the above LPP problem is, final solution is where max of z attain the value 55 and x1 attain the value 4 and x2 attain the value 3. So, this is the final solution for the given LPP problem. I hope now question is clear to you. What is the question? I just explain you again. So, given LPP problem, problem is sub problem 1, then obtain the solution by the graphical method, then after obtaining the non-integer value, we have divided the subproblem 1 into 2 subproblem according to its bound that I have already explained you. So, subproblem 2 and subproblem 3, by graphical method, we have solved both subproblem 2 and subproblem 3 individually. Got the answer for subproblem 2. As this is the integer answer, we left it here. Now, moving for the next subproblem 3, the obtained answer is in non-integer. So, we have to further divide this value on behalf of x2. Okay, taking the lower and the above bound for x2, we have divided the problem into 2, subproblem 4 and subproblem 5. Then we have solved subproblem 4 by graphical method, got non-feasible solution. We'll leave it here. Now solving the subproblem 5, we obtain the answer as an integer form. After obtaining the answer as an integer form, this answer will become the final solution for the given problem. So now I hope this question is clear to you. Branch and bound technique questions are lengthy only. So this is, I have taken the shortest question so that I can explain you. Okay, so if you have any query, just comment me below. Please like, subscribe my channel. Thank you.